Hello, science fans, Bill Nye here, and today we're about to embark on a fascinating journey into the world of technology and testing. Have you ever wondered what keeps your favorite websites running smoothly even when thousands or even millions of people are using them at the same time? Well, that's where capacity testing comes in. Today we're diving into capacity testing, the science of finding out how much a digital system can handle before it slows down or breaks. Imagine a server room buzzing with activity, computers whirring, and engineers keeping a close eye on every detail. Capacity testing is like giving these systems a workout to see just how much they can take. Think of it like testing how many cars a bridge can support before it starts to wobble or collapse, but instead of cars, we're talking about users, data, and digital traffic. Every click, every video stream, every online purchase adds to the load. Capacity testing is a type of performance testing that determines the maximum workload a system can handle while still performing well. It's about pushing the limits, monitoring performance graphs, and analyzing data to make sure everything stays in the green zone. For example, it helps an online store know how many shoppers can browse at once without crashing the site. Imagine a big holiday sale. Capacity testing ensures that everyone can grab those deals without the website freezing or going offline. It's used everywhere. Social media platforms making sure you can post and scroll, streaming services delivering your favorite shows without buffering, gaming companies ensuring smooth multiplayer experiences, and banks making sure you can check your balance or transfer money, even during peak hours. Basically, anywhere lots of people use technology at the same time, capacity testing is working behind the scenes. The goal? To find and fix weaknesses before users ever notice a problem. By identifying bottlenecks and potential points of failure, tech teams can make improvements and keep everything running smoothly. It's all about building reliable, robust technology that works for everyone, even when things get busy. Whether it's a flash sale, a viral video, or a big game, capacity testing helps make sure technology keeps up with our demands. So next time you're online and everything just works, remember, capacity testing is the unsung hero making it all possible. That's capacity testing in a nutshell. Why is capacity testing so important? Simple reliability and trust. Remember the last time a website crashed or an app froze? Frustrating, right? Capacity testing helps prevent that. For businesses, a crash during a big sale can mean millions lost and angry customers. For users, it's about trust, like knowing your bank app will work when you need it. Capacity testing is risk management. It helps companies plan for growth and protect their reputation. It's not just about money. It's about making sure digital services are there when you need them. By understanding system limits, companies can invest wisely and keep users happy. It's the foundation of digital trust. For users, it means fast, reliable apps. For providers, it means staying ahead of problems and building loyalty. That's why capacity testing matters. Let's break down how capacity testing works step by step. Whether you're new to the process or looking to refine your approach, following a structured method ensures you get reliable, actionable results every time. First, define your objective. What exactly do you want to find out? Are you testing to see how many users your site can handle at once, or maybe how your application performs under heavy traffic? Setting a clear goal helps you focus your efforts and measure success. Next, design your experiment. This means creating a test environment that mirrors your real-world setup as closely as possible. Use the same hardware, software, and network conditions your users experience. The more realistic your environment, the more accurate your results will be. Now build a workload model. Decide what your simulated users will do. Will they be browsing, searching, uploading files, or checking out? Try to reflect actual user behavior and patterns, including peak times and different types of activities. Then, run the test. Start with a manageable load and gradually increase it, all while closely monitoring system performance. Watch for signs of stress, slowdowns, or failures as you ramp up the number of users or transactions. Collect detailed data throughout the test. Track response times, error rates, CPU and memory usage, and any other relevant metrics. This information is crucial for understanding how your system behaves under pressure. Analyze the results to pinpoint bottlenecks and breaking points. Look for patterns in the data that reveal where your system struggles. Whether it's a specific component, a type of request, or a certain user load, use what you learn to improve the system. This could mean optimizing your code, upgrading hardware, tuning your database, or even redesigning parts of your architecture. Every insight helps you build a stronger, more resilient system. Repeat the process. Test, learn, and improve. Each cycle brings you closer to a system that can handle real-world demands with confidence. It's a scientific cycle of experimentation and refinement that keeps technology strong, reliable, and ready for anything. Remember, clear goals, realistic tests, and careful analysis are the keys to meaningful results. Don't skip steps. Each one is essential for success. That's the capacity testing method in action, a blend of science, strategy, and teamwork that drives progress and innovation. The first step in capacity testing is setting clear, measurable goals. Vague goals like see how much the server can handle don't cut it. Instead, set specific targets. Support 5,000 users with page loads under 2 seconds and error rates below 0.1%. These are called service level objectives, or SLOs, the promises your system makes to users. Identify key transactions like checkouts or logins that put the most strain on your system. Talk to business owners and developers to understand what matters most. Write down your objectives, maximum users, acceptable response times, and critical actions to test. Clear goals guide your entire testing process. They ensure your results are valuable and actionable. Good science starts with good questions. Set your targets before you test. With your goals clearly defined, it's time to roll up your sleeves and start building your experiment. This is where careful planning and technical precision come together to lay the foundation for meaningful results. Always use a dedicated test environment, never test on your live system. Isolating your tests protects your production data and ensures that your users aren't affected by any unexpected issues that might arise during testing. Make your test environment as close to production as possible for accurate results. Matching hardware, software versions, and network configurations helps you uncover issues that would only appear under real-world conditions. Write scripts for virtual users, simulating real behaviors like browsing, searching, and checking out. These scripts should mimic the way actual users interact with your system, covering both common and edge case scenarios. Use realistic data, unique usernames, products, and addresses to mimic real user activity. The more your test data resembles what you see in production, the more reliable your findings will be. Prepare a mix of user actions to reflect actual usage patterns. Don't just focus on one type of activity. Include a variety of actions like logins, purchases, and searches to see how your system handles real traffic diversity. Set up monitoring tools to track response times, server health, and error rates during the test. Monitoring is your window into the system's behavior under load, helping you spot bottlenecks and failures as they happen. Comprehensive monitoring helps you understand not just when, but why the system struggles. By analyzing metrics and logs, you can pinpoint the root causes of slowdowns or crashes. The more realistic your test, the more useful your results. Simulate peak loads, sudden spikes, and even unusual user behaviors to see how your system stands up to real-world challenges. Build, script, and monitor. These are the pillars of a solid capacity test. Each step reinforces the others, creating a robust framework for uncovering your system's true limits. Attention to detail here pays off later. Double-check your configurations, review your scripts, and make sure your monitoring is set up to capture every important metric. Get your experiment right, and you'll get answers you can trust. Reliable results mean you can make informed decisions about scaling, optimization, and future growth. Ready to test? Let's go. The journey to a high-performing system starts with a well-built experiment. Now it's time to run the test and gather data. Don't overload the system all at once. Ramp up the number of users gradually. Monitor key metrics, response times, error rates, CPU, memory, and network usage. Watch for the inflection point when performance starts to degrade. Correlate user-facing issues with server-side data to pinpoint bottlenecks. For example, if response times spike as database CPU maxes out, you've found a likely culprit. After the test, analyze all your data, create clear reports. System handled 4,500 users before response times exceeded targets. Use graphs and charts to visualize patterns and problems. The goal is actionable insights, not just raw numbers. Good analysis turns data into solutions. That's how you make your system better. Test, observe, and learn. Let's see capacity testing in the real world. Imagine a ticketing site bracing for a superstar concert sale. They simulate hundreds of thousands of fans buying tickets at once. The first test reveals payment processing is a bottleneck at 50,000 users. They fix it, test again, and find the next weak spot, maybe the database. This cycle continues until the system can handle the expected surge. Or take a new multiplayer game capacity testing shows each server can only host 50 matches before lag becomes a problem. Now, the company knows how many servers to buy and where to optimize code. Proactive testing prevents launch disasters and keeps users happy. It's about finding and fixing problems before they hit real users. That's capacity testing saving the day. Science at work. Even experts make mistakes in capacity testing. Let's avoid the big ones. Don't test in an unrealistic environment. Match production as closely as possible. Use real user behavior in your workload model, not just simple actions like browsing. Analyze actual user data to build accurate test scripts. Don't forget about external systems. Mock or simulate third-party services to avoid surprises. Watch out for agreements that limit usage during tests. The biggest pitfall? Poor analysis. Don't just look at one metric. Correlate response times, CPU, and memory to see the full picture. Patterns tell the real story. Pro tip: learn to read your data like a scientist. Good testing is about asking the right questions and digging deep for answers. Avoid these traps, and your tests will be far more valuable. Test smart, analyze smarter. Concerning open questions, ask the NUCIDA QA experts. They will ensure that your tests run smoothly and in a professional manner. That's capacity testing, from basics to best practices. It's not just about breaking systems, it's about building reliable, scalable technology. For businesses, it means fewer outages and happier customers. For users, it means fast, dependable apps and websites. Anyone can start, try open source tools like JMeter or Gatling on your own projects. Build a simple site, design a test, and see what you learn. Experiment, make mistakes, and improve. The world needs more people who understand how to build resilient systems. Embrace the scientific method, ask, test, analyze, and grow. Go forth, be curious, and start testing. The power to build a better digital future is in your hands.